Thank you for joining.
So thank you for the introduction. Can you see my slides? Okay, perfect. So my name is Dario Rodighiero. Currently, I just moved to the Médialab, which is an artistic collective based within the Harvard University and the Berkman Klein Center. And today I will present you a project, which is a data visualization, but also a theoretical reflection about the design of the self, especially the tension that exists between the elements and the collective. So when I started to work on this kind of a representation, of course, the subject was the collective compared to the individual. This is a painting I like a lot that is in Milan. It's called Fourth Estate, and it is a visual representation of a collective. In this case, it was a collective of workers. And you see, it's nice because in this painting, you can see all the faces of people, but you see that the strength of the group is in its collectivity. And of course, the idea of the collective and the individuals is even, we can translate it to academia. And this is the famous painting, The School of Athens by Raphael. The original one is in Vatican, in Rome, and this is the drawing, the original drawing for start a painting that is in Milan. It's beautiful, it's a one-to-one size. And so it's interesting to think about the academia as a group of individuals, because we have many dynamics working in academia, and we have many practices, and we know more or less what we do in academia. So we teach, we do research, and then we have outcome through publication, we attend conferences, we work as reviewers. And this presentation, it's about the representation of conferences as a form of a collective. So specifically, I will present a data visualization to present, to explore conferences to the individuals. And so basically the idea, I mean, this work is between graphic design, interaction design, and also coding. So the idea was to collect all the articles published in a conference. So this one was the Digital Humanities Conference that took place a couple of weeks ago in Ottawa, in Canada. And there were presented during the conference about 500 article, poster, workshop, and so on. And we had more than 1,000 authors. And this is interesting because it's quite challenging. I mean, showing 1,000 individuals, it's a good size. It's a challenging size. And so to do this, I applied instruments of artificial intelligence. Namely, I made use of natural language processing to analyze these articles, and then network visualization for creating a network of people. And if we wanted to go a little bit in details, okay, I think that I've lost a slide. I don't know why. Ah, okay, this one. So this is an example of the output of the text analysis. So on the left, you have a JSON in a JSON format person, specifically he's Matteo Romanello. He's a friend and colleague based in Switzerland. And so it's interesting because two instruments of a text analysis, we can describe Matteo by the words he uses. So for example, the best words to describe Matteo are historical, design, newspaper, mining, revisiting, criticism, challenge, interface, processing, image. And from them, you can have an idea what Matteo is doing. Basically, he's running a project on newspapers and creating an interface to navigate a large data set of the newspapers. But what is interesting in the community is the comparative dimension. So what is Matteo respect to the others? And on the right, we have an example of that, and basically it's a link from the network. So we have Matteo, you can see Matteo from the position, I think. Yeah, this is Matteo, basically from the position. And then you have a second person that is called source in this case, but this is a computer science language. But what is interesting is that Matteo is sharing with this person three keywords. And so they are working on the same subject. And there is the metric to draw the network between people. So imagine these links apply to 1,000 people that it's 1,000 elevated to 1,000. So we have 1 million, 1 billion of relation. And network are very simple because this is the language of a network. So basically you have elements that are connected. And in our case, elements, nodes or nodes are the individuals. And the connection are the keywords in common. Keywords in common give the structure of the network. So the cartography of DH 2020 is based on different graphical layers. So we have the networks based on the links. We have a kind of elevation map, like cartographic maps. We have keywords for each couple of people. We have authors, and we have keywords that are shared between three individuals. So now we run with a little bit example. This is a kind of the composition of the map. So here you see the structure of the network. So the links that are connecting the people, okay. Here you have an elevation map that highlights the most relevant part in the community, okay. Here you have some keywords that can attract you in the navigation of the map. And here you have people. So you have 1,000 people arranged according to their lexical similarity. And finally, we have triplets that we will see later, but basically they show you the groups of people working together. So this is all the layers together. So it's a complex visualization, and you have to use it to understand it. And now I try to switch to a demo and tell me if the share screen is working, because it's a little bit unsure. I can share Chrome. So I switch. Okay, can you see the visualization? Okay, perfect. So basically this is, it's not a demo, it's the application, which is a website. It's public, so you can access it from here. It's on GitHub. And it's interesting because, especially now that we are in lockdown and we don't meet each other at in a place, you can see all the people attending the conference. And so the idea is that through shared keywords, you can have kind of affordances to enter and explore, because the visualization is based on the action of zooming. So for example, I don't know if I'm correct, but if Matteo was involved in newspapers, I have here the keyword, and basically I can zoom the area. And here you have an elevation that is interesting. And you have, if you want, it's a word cloud of keywords. And so you see that in this part, you have people working on historical subject, on newspaper, on literary, on semantization, which is a classic action performer with text analysis. And then basically by zooming, you miss the initial layers to focus on people. And focusing on people, it's interesting because basically you are in the details of the conference. And so you can see groups through the highlights, you can move among people. And basically this is, I think, the group of Matteo. And Matteo is based here. So basically you can select Matteo, you can see with whom Matteo is working, and on the small panel on the left, you see Matteo with one publication, and you can see even the tokens of Matteo. And basically these tokens, I don't want to open the discussion, this technical discussion, but it's based on the frequency. So I can analyze the frequency of awards of all the speakers, and then multiply this with the inverse frequency of the whole community. The result is that I have the most distinguished keywords for each person. And that is, it's an instrument just with the exploration, and you can zoom in and out. And basically the idea is to find yourself and then explore your neighborhood and see which are the most close scholars with whom you share the position the other. So I will try to come back to the presentation again. Hope it's working. How much minutes I have? Presentation is almost finished. I have 1 minute, 2 minutes. Okay, I don't hear anything, but I think one.
Sorry, you were supposed to be finished but at 1:35, but don't worry, you can take your time, yeah, no problem.
Okay, in any case, this is the last slide. So the conclusion is that I draw the self, the collective self, part world self with a network visualization, which is method. Basically, I use the way of distinction between people and similarity, that is calculated with the frequency of the words and the dictionary of each of the speakers. And then I share this visualization during the conference, because the point of using this interface is first the personal recognition of each of us, and then be recognized as a collective, which is very important. And then everything is published as open source, so it's completely usable, and who wants to use this solution can use it. It's quite easy. And my presentation is finished. Thank you.